Who do you believe? So let's discuss now these allegations against Judge Roy Moore and his insistence that they're false. With Trenton Garman, he's an attorney for the judge who also represents the Foundation for Moral Law, which was founded by Roy Moore and his wife. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. I have to ask you, Trenton, you are considering legal action against the Washington Post on behalf of Roy Moore for another story they published, but I want to ask you about these new allegations of sexual misconduct. Why would Lee Korfman or the other accusers make up a story like this?
Yeah, man, it's great to be on here, Don. Appreciate it. Hope that I'll be able to give you the name Don Easy Peasy Lemon Squeezy, right? Gonna make, take it easy on me. It's my understanding from my conversation, though, with your producer that we were gonna be talking about the Foundation for Moral Law and the Washington Post and the prior misrepresentations of the Foundation for Moral Law's conduct. So not necessarily the accusations that were brought up today. So I represent Kayla Moore and the Foundation for Moral Law. And of course, Roy Moore and his campaign will handle the allegations that have been brought against him. I've known Roy my whole life, believe that there is no better man. So glad to be here, glad to process that with you. But that was my understanding of what we'd be talking about.
So what is your take then? I'm sorry, that's the understanding. My understanding is that you came on to talk about all of this. So what is your take on this Roy Moore story in the Washington Post?
Sure. Again, you need to refer back to what the campaign has said. But I will say, knowing Roy personally for essentially my entire life, that I trust Roy. I know no better man. And so defending the Foundation for Moral Law and the way that it has operated and advancing truth as far as the foundation's perspective on moral law, the importance of ensuring that a jury is allowed to hear some of these allegations that have been made about how the foundation has been conducted, is what I have spoken with Chief about, and also what I've spoken with Kayla about. And that's what we sent a recanting letter over to the Washington Post on and have not received a response.
Have you spoken with Roy Moore today?
I have spoken with him twice today.
You've spoken with him twice. And
what is he going to turn that monitor back on up there, please?
What does he say about these allegations? I don't have control of the monitor. No one here does. So whoever's in the studio would have to do
that. Sure, that's cool. Yeah, okay. No worries.
Go on.
Okay. Yeah, I spoke with him twice today. You know, Roy, again, is a family friend. Love Roy. Highly respect Roy. And I've got a 5-year-old daughter that is at home in bed. And so if one were to do what is alleged, then it would be inappropriate. But Roy has come out denying it, and I believe Roy, and I believe that we've had some wise politicians that have deferred judgment and have said if, and we've had some others that have not allowed the process to work its way out. And I think that you know, Don, do an excellent job. Love CNN. I'm a card-toting libertarian, but I think you do a great job of pulling out facts as they arise. And so, you know, I believe that as this story continues to unfold from both sides, that what you're going to see is you're going to see momentum gained by Roy. You're going to see him be elected. And this is me as a friend to the family, not as counsel. I'm representing right now for the purpose of putting the Washington Post on notice, an offer to them to not have us run to the courthouse, but just put back out there a recanting of what you have published. That was, in fact, just not accurate and not true.
So let me ask you something. Let me ask you, so we have a limited time here, and I'm sure we're probably going to go long, producers, so just so you know. So I asked a couple questions at the top of the show, and I said to you, Trenton, that, you know, from personal experience, I know how hard it is for people to come forward. No one knows, except for Lee Korfman and Judge Roy Moore, exactly what transpired. But usually victims don't make these things up, and it's hard for them to come forward. Knowing as a survivor of childhood sexual abuse, I did not tell my mother until I was 30 years old. Why would she or any of these women make up these stories? And my question at the top of the show was, if you were a father, you said you have a 5-year-old at home. If that 5-year-old, fast forward to the future, turned into a 14-year-old and told you the story that Ms. Korfman said, would you believe her or would you believe the man?
Well, the way the question is postured, I think, is unfair to what you're trying to draw out of this. I will say this, Roy.
Why is it unfair?
Every district attorney.
Why is it unfair?
And every judge that has, every judge that has heard those type of cases or prosecuted on behalf of victims definitely understand your perspective and what you're saying. So you'll again need to refer back to the campaign's response. I mean, this is four decades later. So I think it's a both and. I think it's both people get falsely accused mm-hmm. and there are victims of molestation. It's horrible. It's unspeakable mm-hmm. to think that those things go on. But both are true. It's not an either or. And I think that a wise mind that allows for there to be process implemented doesn't knee-jerk, but listens to what unfolds, and there are things that are going to unfold.
I understand that.
The campaign is going to allow.
I understand that, but that's why I said specifically at the top of the show. What I said specifically is a conversation. It's not a monologue.
Yeah.
What I said specifically at the top of the show was that the statute of limitations has run out, so there will be no judge and jury. There will be no process. The process is that a woman has come forward.
I hear you.
On the record.
But hey, Don, lemon squeezy, keep it easy. Here's the thing,
it's
man.
Just lemon. My mom didn't name me. Hold on. Mom didn't name me Don Lemon, keep it easy squeezy. It's just Don Lemon. Go on.
I got you, man. So what I'm saying, Don, is that is just not a factual or legal opinion that's correct. The truth of it is, as someone representing the Foundation for Moral Law and Kayla Moore, we have asked news outlets to represent both sides of the story. There is out there now the opportunity to report, even as it relates to these most recent things, a two-sided part of it. You know, one of which includes Mrs. Courtman at the time probably being 17 and not 14. Okay. But again, the judge has adamantly denied it. And I believe the judge, a four-decade-long wait is unfortunate. But you know, the truth is there are both, and there are both false accusers and there are people who are the victims of child molestation. Okay. God forbid that you know, this continue in our world. Unfortunately, we live in a very fallen world. Mm-hmm. And so I always seek to advocate truth and righteousness. And so I believe the righteous thing to do at this point in time is to allow the process to work its way out. And Judge
but that's
Moore
what
has
I,
come
that, that was my question, Trenton. Forgive me for jumping in here, but that's what I asked you, a minute, 2 minutes ago. What is the process? I've already told you the statute of limitations has run out. So what's the process?
Well, the process, and that, again, is inaccurate. The process is investigative reporting.
What is it? What's inaccurate?
And the process is Judge Moore moving forward with his campaign. You'll have to talk to his campaign.
No. Specifically, hold on. You said that that's inaccurate. What's inaccurate? That the statute of limitations has run out? That's inaccurate?
Well, what you're asking me is for a legal opinion in an issue that I have not been told I brought on for.
That's not what I asked you. I asked you. You keep saying let the process play out. I'm wondering what the process is. That's what I want to know.
I got you. Well, the process here is both sides reporting and Judge Moore continuing his campaign and being elected on December the 12th and us going against the Washington Post for the false accusations.
Just to gain some understanding, so you mean the political process?
People who have now, Don, I'm still talking.
No, just asking you, do you mean the political process? Is that what you're talking about?
Then offered money as false accusers to do this, and there has now been reports that have come out.
So do you mean the political process?
17,
do you mean the political process?
And there's a history of her bringing false accusations against pastors and false accusations against people in the past. So there are both, and there are both false accusers and there are victims. For you to contextualize this as simply a victim story, I think is not in line with the ethics of reporting.
That's fine.
So there are both.
That's fine.
Chief Justice Whitmore is asking you to do your job and to draw out the facts from both sides.
Okay, you said a lot here, but let's hold on. If you slow down, we can talk. We can have a conversation. Okay, so you said.
Yeah, I'm talking. It's part of back and forth.
But you've done a lot of things. So the process, you mean the political process. Is that what you're saying? You're not talking about the legal process.
Well, I'm talking about right now, you and the reporters that are covering stories like this working at the process, number one. And then the political process, I've said again and again and again, Judge Moore, I believe, is going to be elected on December the 12th, but you will have to get with his campaign about that. I recorded the telephone conversation that I had with CNN earlier, and I was asked to come on to simply talk about the Foundation for Moral Law, Kayla Moore, and the accusations made by the Washington Post.
Well, I apologize for that.
And y'all get me on here and you change, you change the scheme of it. And that's totally okay, but again, it's a both and. Both there are false accusers and there are people who molest children. Yeah. I stand by Judge Moore and I fully believe him when he says that he did not do that. I fully believe him 100%. And I believe as the story continues to develop, the facts are that lady was 17, not 14.
Okay,
there are now people that say they were offered money, I'm still talking, by the Washington Post.
You're still talking, but you're now, you still have, number one, you're still talking. But so, you haven't answered the question. Yeah. I said, it's a political process. And you said, well, he's going to go on.
No, I think I gave an answer that you may not have preferred.
You didn't really answer the question.
So
the question is, when you say the process to work out, you're talking about a political process or are you talking about a legal process?
I'm talking about the process of the news media reporting on what the phone conversation I had earlier with Jeff, your producer, was supposed to
be.
It
is my understanding, as my producer said, they wanted to talk to you about this particular story, and we would also
discuss
the other story.
Okay, the beauty is I have it recorded, so
I
know how that works.
That's fine. We'll give you the opportunity to talk about the other.
It's not a joke, you know.
We'll give you the opportunity to talk about the other thing.
And actually, because I'm in Florida, disclosed it, so.
Yeah.
You'll need to talk to the campaign. Judge has denied it. The facts indicate, as they come out now, that the only alleged victim in this situation, again, to both ends, it's horrendous if a young person, against her consent, has something like that happen.
So where is the evidence?
And objective reporters report things like she was 17, not 14. She's made false accusations in the past.
If that is indeed the case,
thousands of dollars have been offered to people.
Let me assure you,
bear witness falsely against
her. That is indeed the case.
You've said that
three or four times.
I'm telling you that
when you've said it three or four times, and you have to let me get in here so that you have to respond to the questions. You have said the exact same thing three or four times. Okay. So again, it's not a monologue.
You must
not be hearing me. So my question is now. If that is indeed the case, you can better believe that the news media.
It's not a question.
The news media will report it out.
What you're framing.
If you will let me finish, I can ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
So the question is, you said that she was 17 instead of 14, and that she has other allegations that she made up. Okay, so where is that information?
Sure.
Where are you getting that information from?
Can I respond to that? Well, again, let me respond to each segment of it. Number one, I said there is out there an investigative opportunity for people to discover whether she was 17 or 14. Again, the door is closed as it relates to Roy, Chief Justice Roy Moore, and his denial of it. He says it didn't happen. But if, in fact, she lied even about the age at the time, just like she's lied in the past, what it does, it actually
diminishes. How do you know she lied in the past if you're saying it's out there? Do you have concrete information that she is? I know you're still talking, but you've said the same thing. This is now the fifth time I think you've said the same thing. So I'm asking you for the proof and the evidence. I'm asking you for the proof and the evidence that she lied. Where did you get that information? And then we can move on or we can discuss it. You're saying it's out there. Just saying it's out there doesn't prove anything.
I get you, man. Hey, my point was this, Don. It actually diminishes, if these allegations are false, people who are really victims. I get that, man. I get the fact, but it's a both and. The Foundation for Moral Law and Kayla Moore have been slandered by the Washington Post. That is why I'm on here. There is no doubt we have written proof, confirmation of it. And the process itself, as it relates to the foundation, and you have to talk to the campaign about Chief Justice Roy Moore.
Okay.
But the process itself, I'm asking you and other news outlets to allow for it to work its way out. Be objective. Here we've given the Washington Post, the Alabama Media Group. We've also given one of the political organizations the opportunity to recant their false reporting prior to this coming out that related to the foundation, that related to Kayla, that even related to Chief Justice. I'm going to be talking with my law partner, Flint Liddon. We're going to be processing what it would look like to move forward as it relates to filing suit. These people don't run to the courthouse. I've been trying to convince them since 2015 to file a lawsuit over all these slanderous accusations that are out there against them. And they keep telling me, no, because these are good people. So it's a both and. Both people falsely accused, because I've seen it time and time again. I've been around the legal practice my entire life, 38 years old, been around it for about 20, been practicing for about 10.
Yeah.
And I have seen false accusers. You would be surprised at the number of them. And I've also seen victims.
No, I wouldn't be surprised. This is a story that I've covered.
Chief Justice Roy Moore was
a
district attorney
that
helped prosecute people who were accusers.
what you're saying.
Through perjury and trials like that, and also the victims of sexual molestation. So he's dedicated his career to be an ambassador of justice. Yeah. So what I'm encouraging you to do is process that out in an objective way. Rather than misrepresent something to somebody, get them on a television show when I've got a recorded phone call and then tell me, it was about A, B, now let's talk about
more
C.
than a minute talking about the reason that you initially wanted to come on and talk about it, and I let you talk about it for probably about 2 minutes.
Well, I didn't want. I was asked to come on, and I'm honored to be here, Don. I'm enjoying the process.
Well, it's good to have you, but I have to ask you.
Hope you didn't get offended, man, when I called you Lemon Squeezy. I was just joking.
I'm not offended.
Like a guy that I went to West Point with.
I'm not offended.
I love CNN. I love watching you.
I'm still talking, so I'll use your words now. I just think
it's kind of hard with the earpiece here, too. Yeah. I apologize.
I understand. Okay. I just think it's disrespectful to call people out of their name. I wouldn't call you some other name than yours. Yeah. Okay. So listen, I'm going to ask you.
Nickname, so it could be an encouraging thing, but go ahead.
I'm going to ask you this. So if you want others to believe that maybe she's not telling the truth and there is something wrong with her story, so I'm going to ask you, what if she did? What if she is right? What if she is telling the truth? Then what do you think should happen?
Here's what I think should happen. The Foundation for Moral Law, Kayla Moore, should proceed with testing the allegations that have been made against them and uncovering the lies that have been made about the foundation. I think the voters should focus on the issues and not allow for what could be, and I think is, a tactic to distract from whether the Constitution and whether the Declaration of Independence are going to be advocated for in Washington. So again, accusers that are false.
Judge
and
Roy Moore, if she's indeed telling the truth.
Roy has spent his life advocating for victims, and Roy has spent his life ensuring that truth is uncovered. So I would encourage people to focus on December 12th on the issues as they are and not these sidebars. Because that clearly,
you still didn't answer
after
my question.
40 years,
are you going to answer the question?
Is a credible question to ask.
Are you going
to
answer
really
the question?
I didn't really understand it.
My question is, if she is telling the truth, what should happen? What should happen to Roy Moore?
Sure. And if who is telling the truth?
If Ms. Korfman is telling the truth.
Well, in an objective setting, if someone is telling the truth in that situation, the process would bear itself out. So I don't know the question you're asking of me as far as the intent, but
I think my question is very direct. If she's telling the truth, she was 14, he was 32, and he sexually assaulted her, I think it's pretty clear that was my question. What should happen to him? I mean, I think
here's my response to you. If she's not telling the truth, what should happen?
That wasn't my question.
I understand what you're saying. In any objective setting, if someone is molested, there should be an opportunity to evaluate that. If someone is falsely accused, there should be an opportunity to evaluate that. Chief Justice Roy Moore has adamantly denied. Chief Justice Roy Moore has a 40-year stint between this accusation, and here it is less than a month before the election. And in my opinion, this is yet another distraction that has been thrown up. And as the facts come out, which I pray you'll report on, to include prior false accusations made by her. Again, it's a both-and. Both there are false accusers
and
there are victims.
You've made that.
You've got to take both of those trails.
You've said that about false accusations a number of times with no proof. And just remember, there's a lot of praying to go around in this situation.
We're not here presenting a case to a jury. The proof is out there, but you need to research it out. So again, I was told that I was going to be coming here to talk about the Foundation for Moral Law, the Washington
Post. You said this is like your seventh time saying that. Thank you, Trenton Garmon. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Up next, while some Republicans keep saying,